Oh, comedian and former dolphin trainer Tommy Little joins us now.
Thank you, guys. Glad to be here. I thought I would give you a quick update on my Wikipedia.
I was going to ask about it. You work on this show, mate.
Yes.
You need to tell us about the blowhole. What happened?
The blowhole.
Safe space.
It was gentle and Flipper and I stood in touch. I looked it up just before. Little's television debut was many years before he shot to fame when he featured on 2 episodes of Rex Hunt's Fishing Adventure as a cod. I think I was on to say about my last stand-up show, which was distributed on Amazon. As part of the show, Little stated he was uncircumcised, comma, to the relief of the audience.
That's good gear. Did you write that just before you came on?
Why is your mum updating your Wikipedia page?
I don't know. Why didn't she circumcise me? Not qualified, probably. Mum, put the tools down!
The parents don't usually do it.
Yeah. Did you not learn from my brother, Mum? He's missing
Tommy,
half of it.
Let me just save the circumcision gear and get back to the questions at hand. I believe you have an unending supply.
Don't cut me short on the circumcision gear. Get it? It was another circumcision joke, everybody. Remember when we had an audience, it was easier.
Now, your new comedy show is called Pretty Fly for a Dickhead, which is very fitting, because you made 3 failed attempts before you got your pilot's license.
Yes.
Has anybody that you know said that they'll go flying with you or been flying with you? I wouldn't in a million years.
No, not one person. Not one person. And it's shattering because my dream is to buy a plane and then I want to travel around the country doing little comedy shows on the weekend in country towns. And I start looking at planes and I'm showing my friends. I'm like, look at this little 6-seater. This could be great. And they're like, bro, get a 1-seater. Like, none of us are flying with you.
So lonely.
I've told you repeatedly I won't. No. I wish you luck, but...
Harry.
No, you're the only one with the death wish, which is why you were doing your next adventure where you were attempting to do something no one's ever done before and you may not achieve.
We're attempting to swim from the UK to Belgium, which has never been done before. Chloe McArdle, the queen of the English Channel, who broke the record for the most number of channel crossings, rang our radio show and... And I said I wanted to get better at swimming because I'm no good. And she said, I've got to swim for you. This has never been done before. And we're going to do it as a team. It takes 50 hours. It's 92 kilometres and it's on July 5th. What do you reckon? And I said, good. And I, at the time, couldn't swim 50 metres. But, guys, I don't want to brag. I did my first open water swim the other day.
It was
500 metres.
Wow.
And I saw a jellyfish, got scared, splashed about so much that salt water went down my throat. I spewed and came third last. And I'm uncircumcised.
Jellyfish is the least of your worries, mate.
Yes.
In that channel.
Yeah, the channel. Yes, the channel's full of disgusting stuff.
I owe you an apology. I saw you last week and I didn't wish you a happy birthday. I didn't realise that the day was your birthday.
I noted it.
I'm on the blacklist now.
But there were so many streamers. You actually pushed streamers aside and popped a few balloons.
Well, it was only when I saw the cake that Carrie had made you.
Yes.
Can you explain what is going on here? What are these chocolate bullets?
That's just swimming between England
and Belgium,
can't you tell?
Because
that's Tommy there in his bikini.
Because is and she knows I wear a one piece, and I write my name on it in case any of these other women try and steal it.
That's his spew.
Yeah.
Why is it brown?
Because I spew poo. That should have been obvious.
And then there was bullets at the bottom.
Okay, I think we can work out what the bullets are.
Apparently, there's floating turds of sewage that go down the channel that you have to contend with as you're swimming through.
That's a fact-based cake, is it?
It's a fact-based cake.
Do you know how good the Bickmore family have been to me? Carrie made that cake, which is so lovely. Yep. And I've got a fear. One of the big things about swimming is you need to wear Speedos. I didn't know this, right? Yeah. So I rock up to a training session. I'm wearing boardies. And people look at me like I'm the weirdo for not wearing my jocks in public.
Yep.
And I just don't have the front-on confidence to wear Speedos. Yeah. And so Carrie's partner, my best friend, walks. He bought me my first pair of Speedos. Look at that. That's not helping. And they were too big.
He rang your mum first and checked before he got it made up.
Yes, and they were too big and I'm uncircumcised.
By the way, I should mention, Tommy's also doing some voiceover stuff for First Dates.
Is that going to go on your Wikipedia?
Guys, I don't want to brag too much, but if you watch First Dates and you hear someone say this, coming up, that's me.
That's you.
Yeah. That is me.
Well, It's fitting because nobody's been on more first dates than you.
And I'm uncircumcised.
That's on Thursday night, you can even say that. Plus, tickets to see Tommy live are on sale right now. Details are on our website. Thanks for dropping by, mate.
Thank you for having me. See you on the show.